Hello and welcome. My name is Nilaus and this is another Factorio tutorials for Angels mods. This time we're going to dive into the most complicated mod in the mod pack, and that is Angels mod Petrochemicals. This is a mod that changes basically anything that involves the oil-based part of the game, so plastics and all the liquids. If we look in the overview, it has a lot of recipes, and these recipes are very difficult, so I'll be making numerous videos on this topic. However, the very first thing you should know when diving into this mod is that, when you start playing, you will see that you don't get oil out of the ground. You will get two different things. You will get gas wells and oil wells. The gas wells, we'll come back to that, and the oil wells, that's where we're going to start. We are only in this episode or this tutorial covering the basics of the oil and gas to get us started, and then we'll dive into the more complicated matters of complex recipes at a later stage. In any case, let's have a look at it. I've put up this warehouse full of multi-phase oil. This is what you pump out of the ground, because of course it's not pure oil that comes out of the ground. It is something in multiple phases, and in order to split these phases, we take it into an oil and gas separator. Quite a clever name, isn't it? And what this does is actually split it into three components. The majority is the crude oil, but we also have something called raw gas, and which is a gaseous form, and some sulfuric wastewater. Now let's start with the so-called waste. The sulfuric wastewater is coming over here. This item here is a clarifier that takes any liquid and just makes it disappear. So just cleanses it. No outputs, no nothing. In the beginning, as you're starting building your first oil base, I would recommend not clarifying this, but actually using this as the source for sulfuric acid. At a later stage, you may not find it useful because it's only 1 in 10 unit that generates sulfuric acid, but definitely beginning, this is a very good source for sulfuric acid. So do not clarify it. Now the other waste, at this point, this is a gas form, raw gas. I'll just store it for now. You see we have a lot of it in here. We'll store it, but it will be useful as we progress. Now, once we've separated the crude oil, it's now time to shove it into our good old-fashioned refinery. But look at that. It's not what we would expect. Usually we would expect to see heavy oil, light oil, and petroleum. But in this case, we have four outputs, and they don't really look the same. In any case, let's go through it. The naphtha is more or less the equivalent of the heavy oil. The fuel oil here is more or less the equivalent of the light oil. And then we have the last component, which is the mineral oil. The mineral oil is something completely different. It has nothing to do with petroleum, but it can be used for other stuff. And then we have, which is the worst part of it, most annoying part, at least in my opinion, is the fact that there's also some fixed, some solid form waste coming out. Now, that means there's not just the usual pipes, but there are also some inserter work here. I recommend setting it up like this because then it fits into sort of nice grid here, and it's manageable. It doesn't lend itself very well to beacons, but I don't really find that to be particularly useful when playing with Angels mods. In any case, let's look at the outputs I'm putting in here. The naphtha is quite a useful component. It's used for cracking into several other things like resin, which is used in Bob's mod. It's also used for several parts of, and you can crack it into some organic chemistry strings. This is more of advanced. This is what we'll go into in the tutorial for organic chemistry, which is later on. The fuel oil is less flexible. But its primary purpose is, as the name suggests, as a fuel oil. It's used for the solid fuel. It's the best way of making solid fuel, and it can also be transformed into other things. Now the last one here, the mineral oil, this has two purposes. One is transforming into something called synthesis gas. We're going to come back to that in another episode dedicated to that. But it is also the only way to, or only real good way of making lubricant, because lubricant does not come from the heavy oil equivalent. So luckily, what we're getting out here, this fixed oil residuals, we can actually take it into this facility. This is called a steam cracker. Interesting that it's a steam cracker when none of it that's coming in here is steam. It takes 10 oil residuals in solid form. Here we go. Thank you for activating. And then it takes 10 purified water. And with this, it creates 10 residual gas, which again is also a waste product. So it just takes a very low grade waste product and enriches it into a less crappy waste product. However, this particular waste product is actually needed for this process. This is the conversion of base mineral oil into lubricant by the use of a bit of residual gas. So that's how we create it, and this will be definitely enough to feed your electric engines and your blue belts. So that's the part we have for the basic oil part. The key outputs are of course these three, but this is nothing to scoff at, and this is something we're going to solve. So basically from this, instead of having three outputs as usual, I mean, in the usual setup you have three outputs, but most of the time you are converting everything into petroleum, so it's just a big blob that generates petroleum. That is not the case. You will have five different outputs and they cannot be converted into each other, at least not easily. So we take this raw gas and let's keep it in mind. Let's have a look at how the default or the basic setup for gas is working. Now again, what you're pumping up out of the ground is called natural gas. I have put it in barrels, and again this needs to go into an oil and gas separator, and this will again separate. It'll separate into something called raw gas. Look at that, that's something we've seen before. Something called gas condensates, which is, I guess it's a liquid form, yeah? And so again, some sulfuric wastewater. The sulfuric wastewater I'm taking over here and clarifying it to get rid of it. But again, I would recommend using it as a source for sulfuric acid. Now, the next part, we actually had, from the oil, we had a waste product that was our raw gas. So why don't we take the raw gas and actually bring it over here? Look, now it's going in here and it's feeding the next part of the process. The gas condensate, we're just going to store it for now. It has a very limited value, but it has one particular value that's very useful. Now, the raw gas, this is why we're here. We're taking the natural gas, converting it into raw gas. And this is again refined into several components, into acid gas, which is, at this point, just store it. Don't worry about it, just store it. It's going to come in handy later, but in my experience it was not something I dove in quite early in the setup. But I recommend making sure there's ample storage for it and then just leaving it there. You can always come back and pick it up later, or I would store it in barrels, but that's just me. Now, what the primary output of this scales in a factor of 20-80, the 80% becomes the natural gas liquids. This is the key ingredient of the gas part of the process. The natural gas liquids is the part that we will continue to do cracking on or gasification on in order to get our organic chemistry going and building the more advanced chains that will eventually lead to plastic. The pure plastic, the joy and frustration of any Factorio game. But this is the key. This is what we want. This is the primary output. So we have this waste product. This is very often, I see a lot of people not using this, just leaving it here, but it is very important that it's used properly because it does have one purpose, and really only one purpose. And that is getting in here. Now we bring it over, and I made this little blueprint here, so it'll be easier to set up. Now, if we look at the recipe here, we take 10 crude oil in, that's a lot, especially considering that what we pump out of the ground is only going to be 70% crude oil. So already there, we're losing 30% compared to our normal process. However, there is a solution, because there are three ways of doing the oil refinery. The basic one, just taking crude oil, the advanced one, which adds a pinch of hydrogen gas. It is much heavier on the naphtha output. I have not used this personally because I think it's a bit of a drag to get hydrogen gas in, and that'll just generate more naphtha. And so far, I haven't really found it to be necessary. However, the one that I always switch to immediately is this one. If you take a look at it, it's 10 out input, that's fine. But the 10 input is actually, 6 of it is the junk, the waste over from the gas part that can only really be used for this. So put it in here, because then you only need 4 crude oil. The recipe is quite heavy on the mineral oil. That's not really a problem, because that is going to be useful. But let's Oh, this is the part that I do not understand why it is like that. But anyway, there we go. So now we have different recipes, and you can see here the liquids coming over from here. They are can be very handy. You also have to, of course, have to remember that you don't run out of this, but I don't think that has not been a problem for me. If that's the case, you can just switch one of them back to the other one, because it's going to be the same output, it's just in different ratios. So that is, that's now emphasizing one of the key points that make this mod complicated. The primary point of making it, that makes it complicated, is the fact that there are so many interdependencies. So the oil is dependent on a residual product from the gas refinement, and the gas refinement is dependent on a product from the oil refinery process, which means that these two processes are going to be linked together and they're mutually dependent. That makes everything more complex. There are kind of a couple of ways of addressing this. One is actually to try to build a balanced setup and then make sure that the input to both to this balanced setup is always enough to keep it running. I'm not too keen on this because it to me seems really fragile. If for some reason you are generating more oil than gas, then the it skews. So what I'm doing is actually I'm trying to decouple this by basically saying, sure, we have this at one location, the oil part, and that generates some raw gas that I need to put to transport. I always put it in barrels, either have robots or trains or belts move it, but never pipes. Never pipes over long distance. It's just too, I mean, fluid mechanics in Factorio, I just don't get it. It's too strange for me. And similarly, the gas condensates, put it in barrels, transport it by a train over to the oil deposit. What is, that's the one part that is complicated on even at the very basic level, this interdependency. The other part is at this point, for example, critically, of most often actually acid gas or sometimes gas condensates. But in any case, you don't do anything and you let it run, and half an hour later, you come back and you've seen that all of your oil production has stopped. And it stopped because the acid gas got full, then that one jammed, then that one couldn't get rid of the natural gas, and because that couldn't get rid of the natural gas, nothing got out, and then that jams up this part because this one can no longer get rid of its raw gas, and then you don't get any oil. So suddenly any one of these that buffers that run full will jam the whole damn thing. That's why I advocate for decoupling it. Then you are not, you can't decouple it. Obviously, if you run out, you run out. But at least on the storage part, do not count on small buffers like this to keep you afloat, and design it correctly from the beginning instead of just saying, all right, this is work for now, head out, kill some biters and come back and see that the oil production has moved for 20 minutes and not 2 hours you've been out killing biters. Anyway, this is an introduction to the start of it, the basic oil, the basic gas components, and all the products, the key products, the raw gas. That's actually not a key product because that's an intermediate product. The key product of the gas part is the natural gas. The residuals are the gas condensates, which again is an intermediate. The acid gas is an intermediate. But then we have the naphtha and fuel oil. Base mineral, I consider that an intermediate because the lubricant is the end state in this case. As I'm building more of these tutorials, I'll be diving into the cracking of naphtha and of these things to more valuable high-end components. Also going to look into the residual gas and the synthesis gas, which is highly flexible. I will look at the acid gas, which combines very well with the Fischer-Tropsch process. And of course, very heavily diving into the gasification and cracking of the natural gas liquids into higher strains of organic chemistry that will eventually lead into plastic. So there's definitely enough to get started on, but at least now we got the ball rolling and got a basic setup for oil and gas to get us started. So thank you very much for joining. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave a like or a comment below, and I hope to see you in a future episode. Thank you. Bye.